أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم I welcome to you all of the biology students to my YouTube channel Biology with Muhammad Abid Malik Now we are going forward towards our lesson is based on binomial nomenclature First of all we try to understand about today's objectives about this lesson So first of all we try to understand about binomial nomenclature secondly we try to understand about who presented binomial nomenclature and in the third segment we try to understand about the rules of binomial nomenclature and in the end we try to understand about the importance as well as significance of binomial nomenclature now we are going forward to start our lesson that's a binomial nomenclature First of all, we try to understand about definition of binomial nomenclature. Binomial nomenclature is the method of giving scientific names to living organisms. In simple scenario, method of giving scientific names to living organisms. Secondly, we try to understand about the binomial nomenclature, binomial words as the word express itself. It is based on two names one name from genus and second name from species so we are moving forward towards the second objective that is that's relevant to who presented it so simply we say that Carolus Linnaeus is a Swedish biologist who presented this binomial nomenclature and introduced it and adopt this system to give the names scientific names for the living organisms Carolus Linnaeus and other scientists also introduced some rules to give the scientific names to the living organism So we try to understand about the first rule. First rule is simple. Scientific names are usually printed in italics, such as Homo sapiens. If we have to see it, that's a italic symbols. Secondly, if we write it in handwritten form, so we underlined the name. Second. The first term generic name always begins with capital letter while species name is never capitalized even when derived from a proper name so that is the second rule now we are going forward towards the third rule the scientific name is generally written in full when it is first used but when several species from the same genus are being listed it may then be abbreviated by just using an initial for genus for example Escherichia coli is a complete name if it is used this genus Escherichia is used first time we write down it into a complete form Escherichia coli if it is repeatedly in genus Escherichia then we use E. coli so that are the three rules now we are going forward towards the significance to avoid all these confusions organisms are given scientific names by using binomial nomenclature in binomial nomenclature every species can be unambiguously identified with just two words Same name can be used all over the world in all languages, avoiding difficulties of translation. So we got an example here. If we have to consider, like I am here in Pakistan, so just as an example, we consider the word onion. As you are well aware, that's also used as a vegetable. So in our different regions, this word onion is used as प्याज इन उर्दू बसर इन पंजाबी और सरेकी आर बस सर दैट आर द वर्ड्स डिफरेंट वर्ड्स विच आर यूज हेयर इफ वी चेंज इट इन टू अ साइंटिफिक नेम देन ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड वी कैन नॉट फील एनी हेजिटेशन एनी डिफिकल्टी ऑफ ट्रांसलेशन सो दैट आर द रीजन्स वी अडॉप्ट दिस बायनोमियल नोमेनक्लेचर टू अवॉइड फ्रॉम द मेनी एम्बिगुअस सेगमेंट्स सो जस्ट I consider some of the examples like onion. Onion having a scientific name, Ilum sepa. Common sea starfish simply, that is the Asterias rubens that have a scientific name of Asterias rubens. If we have to consider the house crow that have a scientific name of Corvus supplendens, that are the some examples. Similarly, we consider the man, that is the Homo sapien, that is the Homo sapien. So, we are going forward towards our last segment that based on evaluation. First question, write down a note, write a note on rules of binomial nomenclature. If you grab it, please mention it in the comments. Second question, describe the scientific names of house crow and man. If you grab it, if you remember it, then please mention it into the comments. In the end, I am really thankful to you. If you feel that our videos are good, so please subscribe my channel, Biology with Muhammad Abid Malik. And secondly, recommend to your friends and forward these videos to your friends. Thank you very much. Take care.